In this video, you will see how to make a full head leather dragon mask. Make sure you have all the necessary materials before you start this project. You can find the link to download the pattern in the description below this video. To print the pattern correctly, choose Actual Size, and A4 page. Cut out all the pieces, and attach them to your leather using regular masking tape. Punch the holes with a 5mm spacing punch tool or with your press machine. Use a 1mm hole punch die. Take your time to cut all the pieces carefully. Or you can avoid all these steps and laser cut the whole thing. An SVG file is also available in the description below. Separate the 12 pieces for the horns from the rest. This will help you work faster. You can start assembling the mask at this point. However, I suggest you take the time to dye your leather and finish the edges for better results. I used Phibing's turquoise color as a base color, and a slight amount of navy blue to achieve this effect. Finish with Resoline. If you find this video useful, please like, comment, and subscribe to watch more videos like this in the future. Find the pieces head top 2 and head side 2. Place the head side 2 below the head top 2 and saddle stitch them together. Continue with the head cheeks too. Don't stitch the part above the eye yet. Stitch the piece forehead too. Now you can complete stitching the head cheeks too. Next, the head jaw two-piece. Continue with the jaw top two. Then the jaw bottom two. And finally, the jaw chin too. Make the stitching as tight as possible. The right side of the mask is ready. Follow the exact same steps to assemble the left side too. Now let's put them together. The strap will help hold the two parts in place. Thank you. The last step to complete the main part of the mask is to cross-stitch the chin. The PDF pattern will help you separate the horn parts. Skive the bottom edge so it will be easier to bend once we attach the horn onto the mask. Start cross-stitching from the second hole and from the bottom to the top. Place the horn so that the backstitch of the horn meets the backstitch of the mask. Once you reach the end of the first part of the horn, leave a gap of one hole. Same for the next gap. The mask hole has three more stitching holes than the horn, so make sure to leave a gap between each piece of the horn. Thank you. Last step, attach 18 millimeter buckles to the triangular part. And the three straps onto the mask.